Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Hope you all are doing good and it's time for a new video tutorial. I have been doing decoupage videos recently and I thought of doing a very basic video tutorial. So this is one of the Fox Leather wallet which I got from Zero Brands and I thought of doing a very basic decoupage technique on this. I actually love the pattern of this tissue paper. I really love this floral pattern and I thought of using this on my wallet. Now usually with the Fox Leather we already use so many colors in that you really can't see the actual finish, the beautiful pattern which the Fox Leather has. So here I thought of using my pattern, the only the design of my flower, and I am going to use it on my wallet as it is. Now to start with, I am going to remove the pattern which I want to use, this bunch of flower, and to remove this flower I am going to use my paint brush with some water and I am going to dip my brush, make a border with the brush on the paper, and then I am going to remove the extra paper from the sides. This Fox Leather has white color, so I really don't need to do any color on it, and my paper really has the white base, so this is actually going to blend in very well with my project. So I actually don't need to use anything of white or any different color in this project. And like I said, I wanted to keep it really simple and I wanted to make something really elegant one, so I thought of using my tissue paper, the proper decoupage tissue paper, on my wallet without any colors on it. Now removing your design from the tissue paper is a little tricky part, but it's really fun. So you just need to dip your brush and make a border and swipe off the extra papers. And yes, you can use the remaining portions in any of your projects. Like this beautiful paper has 3-4 patches of flowers, the bunch of flowers which I can use in my future projects too. I usually prefer removing my plies only after doing the trimming of my design so that it's easy for me to remove, and the other reason is that so that I can use this remaining paper for my next projects. Like I remember I had done a video on mixed media tag, then I have done a video on chalkboard, that's MDF chalkboard, and I use the same paper. So for one project I used the half portion of the paper, for other one I just used a very small piece of the paper. So likewise you can actually multiple use your projects in like papers in different projects and you can work it in various ways. I remember doing a video tutorial on using decoupage papers as your background papers. Now that's really interesting because creating backgrounds is always not easy for everyone, and if you are a beginner it takes time for you to understand on how to do the layering and color combinations and working with new supplies, and already the market is filled up with so many mixed media supplies. Each brand is coming up with something every day, so yes, you really can't spend money on everything to get a nice texture and a background. So in that case, using decoupage papers is also a very good option. I am trying to experiment a lot more with these tissues and hope I'll be able to share some videos very soon. So yes, please do not hesitate to experiment with your supplies, and that's the way you learn, that's the way I have learned, and I'm still learning, I'm still exploring so many of my material now. I know that I really have to trim off only the white border, so now I'm going to remove my ply so that my trimming of paper becomes easy with my paintbrush and my water. So I'm going to remove the ply and then I'm going to use my paintbrush and remove the excessive white color paper from the borders. Removing the extra paper really depends on the kind of detailing you want to show in your artwork. So here I'm going to remove all the excessive white papers, and I'm going to remove the as much as white paper I can so that I have more of a natural look and I highlight more on my flowers and my leaves. This is not going to make much of difference because my fox leather is white, this paper is white, and I've already removed the ply, so this is already very thin. And it depends on you that how much kind of detailing you want to show. Accordingly, you can remove the extra paper from your decoupage sheets. Now I'll be removing the tag from my wallet, and now my wallet is ready to have this beautiful paper on it. So I have decided to use this paper, this particular design from front to back. So I am not going to trim it off. I am just going to make sure that I really stick well on the curves, and I'm going to have the same design, the paper folded on the other side. So I'm going to have different kind of look on the other side of my wallet. Now here I'm just going to mark with my pencil that where exactly I want to place it so that I do not misplace it and I stick to the design where and how I want to stick it. And now the very basic thing, I'm going to use my matte finish Mod Podge and I'm going to apply it generously on my base. For applying Mod Podge, you can also use your sponge dauber, your paint brushes. It's completely up to you that like which material or the which supply you want to use for applying your Mod Podge, but make sure that it is applied very evenly on all the sides. So like you can see here, I'm just trying to figure out if I'm actually covering up the all spaces of my wallet, the design portion especially, and then I'm going to press it and stick my paper really nicely. Thank you. The center portion, I need to be a little careful because this is something where I am going to have my paper, and like I said, I do not want to cut the paper. I really want to give it a very natural look and feel of the single design on my wallet. So I need to be a little careful, and please make sure that you press it very, very slowly because these tissues are really delicate, and I know we all don't want to ruin our project. So now I'm done with one side and it's time to stick the other side of my wallet, and here I'm going to repeat my process of applying Mod Podge generously and evenly on all the sides, and then I'm going to stick my paper. Now while making this video, you can actually see the tissue paper marking, that's the border of the marking, but once it dries out, it really blends well, it gelins with your fox leather, so really don't see any color. Now, like I said, I wanted a white color base. I really wanted a very elegant wallet. So I did not wanted to use any other color in it. And if I'm not using any color, I'm actually focusing more on my floral print, which is a beautiful print in this tissue design. So without even using your colors, you can make your decoupage project look really beautiful, and it's really easy to. Now my paper sticking work is done and it's time to add cellar to it, but before that I need to make sure that my Mod Podge has dried out completely, so that if I apply another coat of Mod Podge on the top of it, I don't ruin my paper and the project looks really good. So usually the Mod Podge can take around 3 to 6 hours, anything in between, it depends on the kind of weather you have. But please make sure that you let it dry completely naturally, that is the best way of drying your Mod Podge. And once you are done with your Mod Podge drying, then you start with the next layer. Now adding Mod Podge here is actually going to save my project for any of the rough and tough hues, and it will give it some extra strength to last longer. So here I'm going to apply two coats of Mod Podge, and I'll make sure that I dry my project really well before applying the next layer, and my project is done. So this was really simple and easy way of doing decoupage, and like I said, it's not at all important, or it's not at all a compulsory thing that every time you do a decoupage you need to add colors. Sometimes the beautiful decoupage tissue papers, the tissues, the thick papers, they really have such beautiful colors and designs that you don't need anything to blend in with. So go ahead, try your decoupage tissues, try your papers, and I'm sure you will enjoy this session of crafting. So it's time to say goodbye now, and I'll be listing all the supplies down in the description box, sharing few more pictures of this video artwork. And if you have any queries, please do comment below, and please do not forget to mention below that what all videos you want me to create. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.